I am a member of the greatest generation. Face it all, you people that aren't a baby boomer. The baby boomers, the greatest generation. And you know why? We brought you the end of the Vietnam War, which probably a lot of you don't even remember as a war anymore, but it was. We brought you LSD, which I see is making a big comeback. And that was fun. That was a fun drug for any of you who, other people who did it. We burned bras, and now we've realized that braless is so much better than wearing a bra. Because even Victoria's Secret with those bras, they're going under. No one wants to wear those anymore. We brought you birth control pills, and didn't that make life just a whole lot better? And it gave you hotter sex, because you didn't have to worry. You had the pills. We brought you The Godfather 1. Unless you're a real aficionado of two, but I liked one. But you can thank my generation for it. We brought you The Grateful Dead. I don't know if there are any deadheads that are still out there, and I don't even know if any of The Grateful Dead are still alive, but it was quite a band. And one of the greatest gifts of all, the best one, a 50% divorce rating. Now, didn't that just free up a lot of you baby boomers and millennials and Gen Xers and all of you generations coming up? You can thank me for that. And what do I get in return? What have you all done for me? Not you baby boomer people, but the rest of you culprits. What have you done for me? I get no respect. I'm invisible, vanished, except for the late night TV advertisers. They seem to know me. How do they know me? But I turn on the TV and someone may as well say, Gail, are you constipated? Not usually that late at night, but I'm Jewish. We are born constipated. So of course I am. Most of my friends are. Although not the Jewish, the ones that aren't Jewish aren't as constipated as the rest of us. I don't know what that's about, but it always surprises me. Gail, are you sleepless? Of course I am, you idiot, or I wouldn't be watching TV now. It's 3 in the morning. I toss, I turn, I sweat, I like curse, I take drugs. I am sleepless. Can you help me? Apparently you can. Gail, do you want flatter abs? And now I'm like, how the hell do they see my abs? So like I get up, I suck in my stomach. I haven't had anything to eat in 4 hours and I still am puffy. And well, you know, if it wasn't 3 in the morning, I would get down and do some sit-ups. But don't we all want flatter abs? Is there such a thing as a flat enough ab? Gail, can you hear the TV? Or is it turned up to a deafening volume? None of your business. That's what I say. And what? What'd you say? Something. You said something, but not sure. Gail, I'm still here. I haven't fallen asleep. I'm still sleepless. Is your bladder leaking? No, my bladder is not leaking. And I don't care how cute you make those pull-up diapers and those little panty liners. They'll never be cute enough, because how are we going to put our yoga pants over them? And I somehow think no matter how flowered they are or checked or whatever you make them, they will never be a fashion statement worn over the yoga pants. Will never be a look. Gail, do you need erectile dysfunction drugs? No, but all my dates do. And oh my God, don't even mention the 4-hour erection, because nobody wants that. I don't think anyone, even a millennial or an Xer or a Z, any of you women, I don't think you want that. If you think you do, you are wrong. So is this the best that all of you millennials and whatever you're calling yourself these days can do for me? Is this it? Well, I'm not really satisfied with that. I think you owe me. I think every one of you under the age of 50 owes me. But here's what you can do for me until you think of something in the interim. Can any of you tell me if a tab of acid from 1972 is still good? Peace.